Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this regular public meeting of Dieppe City Council this 23rd of November. And without further ado, dear colleagues, may we have the serenity to accept the things that we cannot change, the courage to change the things that we can change, and the wisdom to know the difference. So first of all, I'd like to take a couple of minutes to share some important information. We invite the residents. We want to discuss the budget, participative budget. We invite the residents to vote by the 5th of December. The residents of Dieppe can vote in person during the hours at the municipal hall, at the arena, Arthur G. Leblanc, and also at the Dieppe market on Saturdays. For those who want to vote through the web, they can do it. They can do it with their profile number of leisure or with your water and sewerage account number. Or to register as an elector and to have an access code with the municipality. Mobile teams are also going to different places of recreation, and they can offer access codes directly to residents. The choices of the projects are varied. Citizens can consult a description of the different projects and also see a short video of most of the projects. Up to now, more than 700 people, Mr. Leblanc, have already voted up to now. So we hope that people will continue to want to get involved and vote. So without further ado, we have a quorum. Are there any declarations of conflicts of interest? None. So we will go to the adoption of the agenda. Moved by Councillor Leblanc, seconded by Councillor Thibodeau to approve the agenda. All those in favor? On the question, all those in favor signify by saying aye, contrary-minded nay. It is carried as presented. And we go to presentations, inquiries, and petitions. And first of all, item 7.1, inquiries by council members to our Kodiak Regional RCMP. Are there any questions? Councillor Godet. I could mention once again the intersection of Champlain for the left-hand turn on Notre-Dame. I'm mentioning it again. Many people have mentioned it. This is not for the RCMP. This is for our engineering department. Well, yes, but it causes bottlenecks and bumper to bumpers. It's Alain Gillette. I'm told that left-hand turns exiting Alain Gillette to go towards Saint-Anselme on Acadie is very difficult. Could you look into this, please? Thank you. Are there any other inquiries? If not, Mr. Comeau, we thank you and we wish you a good evening. The next item is a presentation of the snow and ice removal plan. Ice removal. Yes, it's the icing on the cake, that's right. Mr. Burke, good evening. Good evening, Your Worship, Mr. Mayor, members of council. This is a broad line. I know this is on a slippery slope, but, you know. So, it is the snow and ice removal plan for the upcoming winter. It seems it's coming along here in Dieppe. And what we want to present, we're going to do this going to be a tag team system. David Knowles, from who's the general manager of the culture, leisure, and community living sector. So he will come and explain a little bit certain details of the plan for the upcoming year. We'll talk a little bit about the history, a little snapshot of the last couple of years. There'll be we'll look back at last winter and then the proposed changes for the transport sector and the installation sector. A little bit of a history. The extra work, 32 kilometers. We're talking about it's 67 kilometers of streets. There are four lanes that have been added. 20 kilometers of sidewalk. 9 kilometers of trails. And more than 300 hydrants that need to be unsnowed every year. At the same time, available resources, and if I just talk about the transport sector, it's public works. We have one operator, we have two pieces of equipment for the snow removal, one charger and a tractor, trackless, that were added. And also, looking at the roads with the added kilometers, we take each road. We added actually two roads over the years. So the result is that it lengthens the time for snow removal of roads. So ideally, if we went to twice in an 8-hour shift, well, right now we can only do one pass over a 8-hour shift. So that's just to give you a little bit of background. If you remember, we had a winter last year that was, we had a little bit of snow. The reference here, we're talking about November to April for statistics. There you have it. It's 506 centimeters. There had been 50 centimeters in November, but the majority was at the end of January. If we're talking about the three blizzards in 7 days, it's 139 centimeters actually between the 29th of January and the 2nd of February. So that's a lot of challenges for the snow removal. Basically, it was the widening of the streets that was a challenge, and the transportation of the snow. There were challenges also with the sidewalks, but especially when it was a question of widening the roads, getting rid of that snow. And at the beginning of the year, if you remember, for services, we kind of regrouped all the operations under one general management. So, in fact, all the services from the operation services is part of one service now. We're talking about public works, water and sewer, facilities, maintenance, mechanics. All that is part of one team. That brought about a lot of positive aspects. There were challenges, but the collaboration of all the sectors was amazing. People worked together, people from the arena who went to take the snow away from the bus shelters, or others who came for the trails. So it was a great collaboration. They each had their tasks, but at the same time, there was great collaboration between the services. And that's something that makes me proud, to see that people worked really well together. Also, we worked on the enhancement, continued enhancement. How could we do things better? There'll be some more information in other presentations later on, but it's something that increased efficiency. We won an award from the Moncton Transportation Club. The three communities received the award to for the efforts in snow removal over the last winter. And it's the staff that basically received the award. So that was very well, much appreciated. Now for the, to explain a little bit the changes to the plan, because there are certain changes that we are proposing to, as a matter of fact, to try to be more efficient in the snow removal. And I'm going to ask David Knowles to explain the different changes for the transportation sector. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, Mr. Knowles. I'm going to start with a little bit of a background to give you an idea of the number of kilometers and things like that for the snow removal. We have 161 kilometers of street to plow. That represents a total of 356 kilometers of roadway. We have 62 kilometers of sidewalks to plow, 1,352 hydrants, and 31 parking lots. Proposed changes, a couple of little things. The reduction of plowing of sidewalks by 2.4 kilometers between Dieppe Boulevard, on Dieppe Boulevard between Chartersville and Melanson. The reason for that being that there's a trail on the other side of the street is plowed. We also are working on prioritization of sidewalks. We're going to be plowing sidewalks that we call priority one, within 1 hour after the end of the snow. And then the other sidewalks, priority two, will be plowed in the 3 days following the snowfall. The reason for that is that we're going to be prioritizing our employees of human resources on the roadways. And that will be, these changes will be helping us in the plowing of the roadways. We're also going to be adding a trail in the marsh. Two passes, hoping that, we believe that it's going to take two passes using the trackless on the sidewalk in order for the trail or the sidewalk to be wide enough to be able to walk. So with these two changes, the Dieppe Boulevard and the marsh, we are hoping that will be sufficient changes to help. We're going to be plowing the same number of kilometers, but a little bit less of sidewalks. We're also suggesting changes around the municipal plus 1604, take up the snow, move it out away from the sidewalks and the parking lots along Champlain and the Marchés and the market within the 96 hours following the storm. Was 48, we would like 48, but reality, it'll probably be 96. We're also going to be removing snow around the hydrants, according to the priorities, and with the collaboration with the fire department. So we're going to do it as quickly as possible. Last year, we had a snow dump on Aviation Boulevard on the eastern side of the public parking at the airport. This year, it will not be available for us, so we will have to go back to Benjamin Street and use land of the municipality there. We have a map here. It's the map of the town, of the city. It shows you that the city, the streets are divided in three different categories. We have Champlain Street, or the main one. We have collector streets are in blue, Chartersville, Gauvin, etc. And we have the, in yellow on the map, these are local streets or residential streets. The city is also divided in four different groups on roadways, different colors on the street. For example, there's a piece of equipment for each of the colors. We also have a map of sidewalks divided in two categories. The brown color are priority one, that's the business sector, school zones. The yellow is another priority. And this year we've added a map for snow dumps. We didn't have this type of map in the snow removal plans last year. The green one arrows show the dumps that are going to be used. Benjamin Street, Ruffin Street next to the Operation Center, and there's another one on Cop Street. In yellow, we identified two places. They will be used for extreme winters, like last winter. It's not our intention of using those yellow spots for a normal winter. These five areas that I mentioned belong to the municipality, but this one is for sale, so it's just temporary. The one indicated by a red arrow on Lakeburn, just after the airport, we're suggesting this site for a snow dump in the future. Good evening, Mr. Mayor, members of council. So it's my turn to present to you the plan for snow removal for trails. So the municipality, just give you some background on the trails. The municipality has 35 kilometers of trails. This does not include the trails in the Rotary Saint-Ancel Park. It's another snow removal team that will be doing those. The plan for the next summer foresees 23.6 kilometers of plowing. That represents 67% of the trails which will be plowed. That means that we have 33% chances of having some complaints. I don't think so, because some of those 33% have never been plowed. You'll see that in my presentation. Concerning the changes proposed, we have a reduction of plowing of 7.2 kilometers. It's mainly the trail that starts at Pointe-au-Renard and that goes to the Dover Road. We did it last year. There were challenges. Plowing was represented challenges. It was dangerous for staff. So we are suggesting to stop doing it because there's very little connection from one extremity to the other. So for this winter, this part of the trail, we are suggesting not to plow it. In the future, we see that there'll be connections. So then we could look into replowing a certain part of the trail. Another change will be that there will be no plowing in the parks except for the Rotary Saint-Anselme Park. We're going to be doing a little bit of plowing in neighborhood parks, those who are, which are part of a trail network. We're also going to be prioritizing snow removal. There are two priorities. You have the map in the document. There's priority one, which is the trails in green, and those will be plowed within 24 hours following a storm. We're basing ourselves on a 30-centimeter storm as a parameter, And it's mainly in the regions around schools. There were schools where the bus stops, we want to prioritize secure safety of youth. So for P1, green, there's 7.4 kilometers. Once again, we plan on doing it within 24 hours after the snowfall. The trails in yellow, P2, those will be plowed during the regular hours of work, and the time necessary to complete the plowing will be 5 days after completing the P1, and the P2 yellow ones represent 16.2 kilometers. The map, you have it in front of you. Are there any questions on the map? But otherwise, that concludes my presentation. Thank you. In fact, I think it concludes the presentation on snow removal, and we will go to the question period by members of the public, question of members. First question will be for Public Works. I would want to know snow removal of sidewalks on Champlain and on Market. Before that, the norm was 48 hours. Now it's going to be 96 hours. What was your experience? What do you think? Is your possibility of what was the problem in not doing it in 48 hours? We're going to be removing the snow of the sidewalks. Right now, it's to eliminate and transport the snow after the storm, after the snowfall. We just don't have the available resources to be able to meet those requirements within 48 hours. Yeah, but my question was, what was your experience last year? How long after was it done? Was it 60 hours, 72 hours in general, as an average? How long did it take you to do that? I think 96 hours is the reality, is the average. It depends on the type of snow, the type of snowfall, but the average was 96 hours. 24 hours is just 48 hours. No, sorry, 40 hours is just not realistic. So I'm wondering if it was because of the enormous amount of snow that we had continuously, week after week, humongous snowfalls. The previous years, or the years before that, was the 48 hours was something that was 48 hours was okay? In the preceding years, yes, it was okay, but it still presented problems. Every year it became more and more difficult because there are added roads, streets, sidewalks. My question is that, Mr. Mayor, is that we establish norms according to the snowfall of last snowfalls, yes. But if we figure that last year was abnormal, and if we're capable of going back to something that's more reasonable, obviously without knowing beforehand. My other point, Mr. Mayor, is has to do with the trails. Do I understand properly that there'll be one side of the Dieppe Boulevard between Charlottesville and Melanson, one side that will be closed and one side that will be maintained open, plowed? Is it the trail or the sidewalk? The trail will be plowed. The sidewalk will not be plowed. So we have to make sure that we inform the people when we do that, because it's still part of the city where many people walk. Yes, I think that the reasoning was that on the trail side is where you find the majority of the population, with the apartments, the condos, the eastern side, yes, rather than the other side where the sidewalk is. I think that's how the choice was made. And my last point is on trails. There fewer. There's 7.2 kilometers fewer than on sidewalks. Does that represent a reduction in staffing? Or that section between Pointe au Renard and Dover Road that represents 5.2 kilometers, that will not be plowed this year. And it's a section that I can give you an example. In the village, the S, it took 5-6 hours at one point to do this, and there were very dangerous situations sometimes. So just that part is 5.2 kilometers. From Puente Renard to Dover, to the little hill, to the end, to Dover Road. And there was no possibility of removing the snow and to close once you reach to the pass, to the little bridge. Yeah, but that doesn't bring people anywhere. There's no connection. That's what I explained earlier. We're working to make connections. Unfortunately, we haven't been able to make, we haven't been able to purchase the lands this year yet. Thank you, Madame la Conseillère Dallaire. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My question also is for Public Works and concerning your pieces of equipment that are affected to specific areas. Once they finish their part, what happens to these pieces of equipment? Will they go help the other areas, or do they go back to the operations center? I got some feedback on last winter that there were snow removal people who were waiting for some streets to be plowed, and when they finished, they went back to operations instead of helping other places. Normally, when they finish their places, they I can't talk about specific details, but if we have to manage the amount of hours worked, it's 16 consecutive hours. If the person has already worked 16 hours and he stops and he's got to take a break of 8 hours, so it's a possibility that that was the case. But I can tell you that we used our human resources and in our equipment resources properly all the time. Thank you. Having had the opportunity to be in a big, big snowplow with a big, big wing, I can tell you that it's you got to be in shape to do that. This is extreme sports. I was there, and I admire the people who have to do the job and manage these situations. It's difficult work. Sorry, I didn't want to interrupt you. If you had anything else to add, Madame Dallaire. Thank you, Mr. Conseiller Godet. One of the questions that comes up on a regular basis is the question of priority. People say, well, we're always the last ones to get plowed, especially in P2. Is there an alternating aspect of the priorities that could maybe balance things out so that it's not always the same cul-de-sac or the same streets that are plowed last? We had considered changing every year, but it's complex in the sense that we want, when the equipment leaves the operations center, we want them to start removing the snow as soon as possible. We don't want the equipment to move around without snow plowing, to start far. We want them to start immediately. So the way of conceiving all this is, I think, is represents the best way of doing things for the snow removal. There's always changes to make, and we're always looking for them, but we have to start somewhere and we have to end somewhere. And there's certain streets that have to be done at the beginning, some at the end, but it would really complicate things for us and for the operators. I understand this challenge, and, well, thank you still for thinking about it, and thank you for putting all these pieces of equipment to work as fast as possible. Another question, the hydrants, the fire hydrants. we remove snow around fire hydrants in regions where there probably will be no use. Have you counted with the fire services how many hydrants could probably be actually forgotten, would represent some efficiencies? To our knowledge, we haven't reached that point yet, but maybe the fire chief could, Fire Chief LeBlanc, just to answer the question, what we're going to be doing this year is to prioritize the sectors where the priority is established for risk, for danger, etc. After that, they'll do the rest of the fire hydrants as they have time to do them. So it's a little bit difficult that the fire hydrant is not going to be used because it's there for a reason. So there are standards that say how far away they have to be from buildings and things. There's systems, but so I don't think we're going to be deciding not to do them at all, but it's a question of prioritizing. And with we've already had a meeting with the engine, the department, and also we have shovels in our trucks. We've always had with the public works services, we can call them in case there's an emergency call. Then they'd meet us there, and they'd be doing the snow removal at that point. Yes, because we can see that there's certain streets, certain sections in the woods. There's no houses within serviceable distance, and yet we still remove the snow around them with the same type of priority as the others. So I encourage you to take a look into this. It could represent maybe a little bit of a savings, but still important. And I can tell you also that, Mr. Knowles, that the blowers in the last winter, with the added difficulty that we had, well, the blowers were really appreciated and noted as being efficient to widen the streets, but also to clean the secondary or the neighborhood streets. It's far less frustrating to see the blower coming by to widen the streets rather than the plow that also blocks the driveways that will have to be blown away also. So, and I know that, Mr. Mayor, you said that the trail that was going to be cleaned or plowed is where the was more population. And if you remember that I had mentioned something in the same sense, so that the sidewalks or the trail in the marsh had to be plowed for the same thing. Well, right now we have to realize that in the marsh there's not that much of a population.
Next, Councillor Thibodeau. Thank you, Your Worship. I want to talk about the reduction of the snow removal between Chartersville and Melançon on Boulevard Dieppe. I see a lot of older people who live at Auberge du Soleil, and they walk on the sidewalk on the east side. And now it's the other side that we're going to plow. I think the people who are in the other side are in good shape and could more easily cross the street than the older people that are on the east side. It's the side on Auberge du Soleil that'll be plowed. Oh, okay. I thought it was the opposite. Yes, the side that has the most population. On the other side, there are golfers, so they don't play a lot during the winter. Excuse me, I had understood the opposite. It's something that hasn't even been mentioned tonight. We want to encourage citizens to plow their own hydrants, those in front of their houses, which help to protect their properties, their houses, and those of their neighbors. I know last year we had a lot of success with this program, and I'm looking forward to hearing people talk about the program so that people will be encouraged to do this. I saw pictures of young people, children even, who were taking the snow away from the hydrants with their parents last winter. So I'm convinced that we will surely hear, speak of you soon on this file. Yes, adopt a hydrant, that's it. I don't see any other questions, so I think it's clear as a good snowstorm. So we're getting ready. Here in Dieppe, we're ready for it. Generally, I think all members of council, and I speak in the name of the council, we want to congratulate our workers for their work. We receive a lot more flowers than pots of flowers when we talk about snow removal in Dieppe. Thank you. The next item on the agenda at a regular council meeting, the adoption of the minutes. Moved by Councillor Cormier. Excuse me, we're at questions by members of the public. Mr. Evans, you have a question for us tonight?
I will take advantage of the excellent bilingual services provided by the City of Dieppe, as has always been provided by the City of Dieppe, and like our neighbors to the west, still can't understand how they got an award for that. Don't have any questions, but I do have two comments.
Yes, please.
First comment is, excellent job. I'm going to state the obvious here. An excellent job in the marsh. I think the construction company did a fantastic job in keeping the traffic moving. In that whole summer, I never heard of one accident or one untoward incident, which I think is an incredible record for such a complicated and huge undertaking. I want to thank also the members of council and the staff of the engineering department, who obviously put a heck of a lot of work into all of that. I think that was absolutely brilliant. We should be very, very proud of ourselves in the City of Dieppe for that. Second point I want to make is, RCMP have been requesting an increase in their budget. I don't know what deliberations the council have made so far, but I strongly want to urge the council to absolutely pass this request for extra money. We do not want to go through the awful situation that we went through last year. And I hope that that consideration will be in the forefront of the councillors' minds when they make the deliberation. I think it is a relatively small amount of money considering the number of citizens in Dieppe. We receive excellent policing services from the RCMP here. I don't want to see us go back to a city police force. I'm old enough to remember our city police force. Not that they were bad, but I honestly believe that they could not possibly give the kind of service that we have come to expect from the RCMP. Very much for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Evans. Certainly, when it comes to the budget deliberations, I will start tomorrow evening, and we'll go on. I think we start early tomorrow, 5:30. So we'll start tomorrow evening, 5:30, with council deliberations on budget, and continuing the next day and the next day if necessary. So we'll see how it goes. Appreciate your comments. Certainly our the engineer in charge of that project, Mrs. Angèle Spencer, did a tremendous job working with the contractors. We've had, again, there nothing but flowers. And it's always more pleasant when it happens that way. But I think we also need to congratulate our communications department, who did an exceptional job of keeping everybody informed through direct emails as well as press releases. That's what I was short for words here. Press releases, and also through different social media. So I think everybody is very happy with the outcome. There's a little bit more work to do, and heck, maybe we'll throw a party when it's all done. So, all right. OK, merci encore une fois. Alors maintenant, on avait la résolution pour l'adoption des...
Now we have the resolution for the adoption of the minutes of the last meeting that was held on November 9th, moved by Councillor Cormier, seconded by Councillor Dallaire. For the question, all those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary-minded, nay. The minutes of November 9th are adopted as presented. Now for item number 10, motions and nominations. 10.1, unsightly premises. Mr. Melançon. Good evening. We have a property on 1742 Amiro. It is recommended to proceed with this resolution and to take measures to recuperate costs by the cleaning of the property. So I think we should adopt this resolution. It's for your consideration. Thank you. For the reading of the resolution, Councillor Thibodeau. Thank you, Your Worship. The Council authorized the personnel designated and responsible of this matter to have removed the debris located at 1740 Amiro Street, PID 00820548, and 1742 Amiro Street, PID 701278400. And to undertake the necessary steps to be reimbursed the cleaning costs by the property owner pursuant to the provisions set out in the Municipalities Act. I so move. Moved by Councillor Thibodeau, seconded by Councillor Godette. For the question, all those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. The resolution is adopted as presented. Next item, 10.1.2, request for support, GMSC plan upgrade, sewage collection and treatment facilities. Mr. Melançon, as you know, to be in conformity for the 2020 federal regulations, the Commission wants to present a project to Build Canada. We have partners. We are partnering with the Commission. They're asking for our support without impacting our first priority. So this is a regional project, and we should be sending a letter of support as soon as possible to support this project. So we want the support of the Council. For the reading of the resolution, Councillor Brideau. Thank you, Your Worship. That the Dieppe Municipal Council endorses as a high priority the Greater Moncton Sewage Commission, also known as Transaqua, plan to upgrade its sewage collection and treatment facilities to meet the new federal regulations by 2020. Provided that the plan's funding does not prevent or adversely affect the City of Dieppe from obtaining funding for other infrastructure programs under the Building Canada Fund and for which the province of New Brunswick would also be a financial partner. The Council sent as expeditiously as possible a letter signed by the Mayor to the GMSC endorsing its plan to modernize its sewage treatment facilities to meet the new federal regulations by stating it constitutes an infrastructural regional priority. The GMSC will then send said letter to Members of Parliament and Legislative Assembly. I so move, Your Worship. Moved by Councillor Brideau, seconded by Councillor Thibodeau. For the question, all those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary-minded, nay. The resolution is adopted as presented. Item number 10.2, Culture, Leisure, and Community Life, 10.2.1. Mr. Melançon. On September 14th last, we received a petition and a request for a park at Pois du Renard and at Boiteau Street for a playground. So we looked at our master plan, and this park is within an acceptable distance within our plan. We did a survey as well for the proximity of this park and the population of youth in the era. So that was identified. So with all these lessons, it was recommended not to proceed with this playground and to leave it at the same place where youth have access to a playground with a trail as well. So after evaluation, the recommendation of the staff wants to leave the park at its present location. For the reading of the resolution, Councillor Dallaire. The council accept the recommendation of the Culture, Leisure, and Community Life Department not to develop a new playground on La Boiteau Street in Pointe-au-Renard subdivision in 2016. Moved by Councillor Dallaire, seconded by Councillor Thibodeau. For the question, Mr. Leblanc. Thank you, Your Worship. Did I understand well that we have done an evaluation, or have we done an evaluation between Capin Street and Pointe-au-Renard to see how many youth would be using this playground? We could ask Mr. Bourque for details. The two parks, parks for public services, are in this area. We counted the number of youth, and the figure was high enough to justify a playground. So the first part of the recommendation is that the park remain on the Rue du Copain because there are youth in that area, and the public uses land is at 300 meters from the park on Capet Street, and we need 800 meters of a distance to be able to reach all the people that are in the area. I know that one request is to move the one on Copain Street to A Boiteau. Are we going to add the number of children if we move the park? It's about the same thing because the radius is about the same from these two playgrounds. At present, there are more youths near Boiteau and Pointe-au-Renard, but the figures are still high enough, and we don't want to recommend it. Thank you, Councillor Godet. For the people in Boiteau and Jean-Charles and Gillespie streets and other streets, it's quite a distance to walk. I think 800 meters may be right. But if you take the trail, it's closer. The last time that I was there, I saw that from Boiteau Street to the trail, the work hadn't been finished or wasn't very good. It hasn't been finished now, the work there. I believe so. The access on Copain Street to the trail is there. From the trail to Copain Street, it's okay, but from the trail to Boiteau Street, has the work been completed? Yes. The last time I went there, in the middle of the summer, it was not easy to get to. Yes, I was told it's been done, but I could check. I would like to add, Your Worship, or propose an amendment to the resolution that could be read as follows: to not build another playground on Aboiteau Street at this time in the Pointe au Renard subdivision. An amendment to the resolution. Anyone to support it or second? All those in favor signify by saying aye. Against, no. The amendment is accepted. Any more questions? If not, we'll go to the resolution as amended. All those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. Councillor LeBlanc says no. Thank you. The resolution is adopted. The next item, 10.2.2. It's recommend to authorize the payment of $270,950 to BNP Strategies Atlantic. We want to do research for new funding sources for recreational community projects. And this will be defrayed from the general operating fund. So we need the authorization of council for the reading of the resolution. Councillor Béliveau. The council authorized the payment of $270,950 plus HST to BNP Strategy Atlantic to research new funding sources for a recreational community project, and that this expenditure be defrayed from the general operating budget. I so move. Moved by Councillor Béliveau, seconded by Councillor Dallaire for the question. All those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. The resolution is adopted as presented. 10.2.3, grant request. It's resolve that the city give $1,000 to the Maître Tolls Music Choir, and this would be to buy equipment for the choir that could be used by the Dieppe choir and those of the tri-communities as well. So it's for your consideration. So this is a regional project. Yes. For the reading of the resolution, Councillor Nolan. That council authorized that a grant in the amount of $1,000 be given to the Maître Tolls Music Choir, and that this expenditure be funded from account number 12-2028-2310, grants to organizations, unforeseen requests. I so move, Your Worship. Moved by Councillor Nolan, seconded by Councillor LeBlanc for the question. Councillor Béliveau, thank you, Your Worship. The question is, are there residents that are in this choir? Have we checked? What is the percentage of the choir are residents of Dieppe? I don't know, but I'll come back with you with that number. I had a request from a member of the choir who's a resident of Dieppe. And this will serve all choirs in the region. And as you know, we have a lot of citizens of Dieppe who take part. We all know some of these people in different choirs. So there are people from Dieppe that are members of this choir. Yes, of course. So they are making this request. Yes, for the benefit of all the regional choirs as well. That's in the agreement in this grant, for this grant. That's clear. Councillor Thibodeau, I was wondering, when you talk about a project for the region, are other municipalities, have they been asked to give the same grant? Yes. the City of Moncton was very generous with respect to this project, and we wanted to take part as well. I suggest that you participate in this project. Thank you. For the resolution, all those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary-minded, nay. The resolution is adopted as presented. 10.3.1, expropriation in the Acadie Amiro project in the marsh. There's going to be reconstruction, and we need compensation. There's one property that we can't agree on the prices, so our legal counsel suggests that we go to expropriation while continuing discussions so that it will not stop the construction of the project next year. So we've been advised to go through these three steps. Mr. Noel suggested that we have an amount for compensation and to get the authorization of council to proceed. Thank you for the reading of the resolution. Councillor Cormier. Thank you, Your Worship. The council received the report of the Expropriations Advisory Officer, Mr. Jonathan Rock Noel, dated November 2nd, 2015. Authorize that a notice of expropriation be issued with respect to the land described in Schedule X of the notice filed in the Land Registry Office, New Brunswick, on October 1st, 2015, as number 35305482, and authorize that the amount of the compensation and legal fees be defrayed from account number 33358-7608, General Capital Budget Reconstruction Acadie Amiro. I so move. Moved by Councillor Cormier, seconded by Councillor Thibodeau for the question. Councillor LeBlanc. Thank you, Your Worship. There are no other properties in the marsh section that we could use as an exchange with respect to this expropriation. I'm looking at my colleagues, but I think this was the best area. This was problematic to put it into acceptable condition. So we chose this property . This was a point that was accepted by the province as well with respect to the environment. You can't just give away any property. There's regulations attached to that. Yes. Councillor Bidivaux, thank you, Your Worship. The documentation that we received gives the impression that this property was a wetland and it was filled. Who gave permission to fill it in the first place? I don't have the answer to that. That took place a long time ago. Perhaps things were done that way at that time, but I don't have an answer. So we're asking Mother Nature to take back this wetland and we're going to put it back into its original state. Yes. So that's something that will cost us to buy the property, and then we'll have to remove the fill-in. Yes, we're going to put it in acceptable condition. So I would like to know what the costs would be. Mr. Desjardins, do you know? We'll come back to you with that figure. Yes, in future projects, perhaps you could add the cost. Councillor Godette, this property and this space that was filled in many years ago is all this property still marshland in its natural state? Yes. the property that we wanted to buy was filled in at some point. And if you look on the plan we gave you, it's already in its natural state. On the drawing, on the left side, there seems to be a color that's different that would indicate work or addition. The property in red, at the limit of the marsh, there's a part of the property that has not been filled in. Thank you. I would like to know how much it will cost to make these repairs.
So, if there are no other questions, all those in favor signify by saying aye, contrary minded nay. Carried. Appointments 10.4.1, Planning Advisory Committee. Somebody to read the resolution. Councillor Blanc. Thank you, Your Worship. That Council appoint Paul Le Breton and Robert Arsenault on the Planning Advisory Committee for the another term ending on December 31, 2018. So moved. Moved by Councillor Blanc, seconded by Councillor Brideau on the question. All those in favor of the nomination signify by saying aye, contrary minded nay. Carried as presented. Public Works. Snow and Ice Removal Plan Resolution. Mr. Thibodeau, please. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Council approved the levels of service and the priorities outlined in the City of Dieppe Snow and Ice Removal Plan, dated November 2015. So moved. Moved by Councillor Thibodeau, seconded by Councillor Dallaire on the question. On the question, Mr. Béliveau. Thank you, Your Worship, Mr. Mayor. I haven't noted that there was a reference to snow removal of the parking lot of the second fire hall. Is it a detail that it did not notice, or is it an element that it's understood without saying that it's included? But the first fire hall is distinct, it's well described. The description of what parking lots are going to be cleared, but I don't see the fire hall. The second fire hall will be cleared like the first one. We'll make the appropriate changes in the plan. There'll be a follow-up. Yeah, it's just that I noted that I hadn't seen it specifically. Well, maybe to make sure that the new firefighters stay in shape, that they'll do it with shovels. Thank you. No other questions? All those in favor of the resolution signify by saying aye, contrary minded nay. The resolution on the snow and ice removal plan is carried. Item 11 on municipal bylaws. We'll proceed with the bylaw C-19 authorizing the City of Dieppe to stop up and close any or any portion of a highway within the City of Dieppe. Item 11.1.1, reading in its entirety. Somebody who's feels like doing it. Councillor Brideau. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Bylaw number C-19, a bylaw authorizing the City of Dieppe to stop up and close any or any portion of a highway within the City of Dieppe. Be it enacted by the Municipal Council of the City of Dieppe, whereas Section 187 of the Municipalities Act, Chapter M22 of the Statutes of New Brunswick, 1973, authorizes the Dieppe City Council by bylaw to stop up and close any or any portion of any highway or street, or portion of any highway or street, including any public street, road, lane, alley, or way within the municipality, And whereas it is deemed in the public interest that the portion of Paul Street extension identifies as parcel 15A, as described in Schedule A, hereto attached, be permanently closed to all forms of traffic, now therefore be it resolved that from the date of ordaining and passing of this bylaw, the portions of the public street herein mentioned and specified in Schedule A is permanently closed. Moved. Without a doubt. Moved by Councillor Brito, seconded by Councillor Cormier, that we adopt bylaw C-19. Questions? No questions. All those in favor of the resolution signify by saying aye, contrary minded nay. Bylaw C-19 is accepted in its entirety, and we will proceed by we will proceed to third reading by title only. And Councillor Brideau. Bylaw C-19, a bylaw authorizing the City of Dieppe to stop up and close any or any portion of a highway within the City of Dieppe. So moved, Mr. Mayor. Moved, third reading, title only, seconded by Councillor Cormier. On the question, all those in favor, signify by saying aye, contrary minded nay. Bylaw C-19 is carried. Item 11.2, which is bylaw 9, which is amending a bylaw respecting traffic and reading in its entirety. So, Mr. Béliveau, if you feel like it. Mr. May, bylaw number 9, bracket 27-2015. A bylaw, an amendment to a bylaw number 9 of the Municipality of Dieppe respecting traffic. The Council of the City of Dieppe, duly assembled, hereby enacts as follows. A, in subsection bracket 1, I, by adding after paragraph 7 the following. 7.1 Beauséjour Street, A, east side for the entire length of the street. II, by adding after subparagraph 27A, the following. B, west side from December 1st to March 31st. So moved. Moved by Councillor Béliveau, seconded by Councillor Leblanc on the question. All those in favor, signify by saying aye. That's bylaw number 9 in its entirety. Signify by saying aye. Councillor Thibodeau, you had an amendment? No, I think that you'd forgotten to turn my mic off. Okay. Okay. All those in favor of the adoption, signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. Accepted in its entirety as moved. Now for the third reading by title only. Mr. Béliveau. Mr. May, bylaw number 9, bracket 27-2015, a bylaw and amendment to a bylaw number 9 of the Municipality of Dieppe respecting traffic. So moved. Hey, this is contagious now here. Third reading by title only. Thank you. Moved by Councillor Béliveau, seconded by Councillor Leblanc. On the question, Madame Dallaire. Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'm going to move an amendment, item 5.2, that Aviation Street become Aviation Avenue, Avenue de l'Aviation. So there's an amendment. That we add Avenue de l'Aviation. And I think that Councillor Thibodeau is going to second this motion. On the amendment, are there any other questions? If not, all those in favor signify by saying aye, contrary minded nay. Okay, the amendment is accepted as presented. Now, for the final resolution by title only. All those in favor of the bylaw as amendment signify by saying aye, contrary minded nay. Thank you to all. Bylaw number 9, bracket 27-2015, accepted in its third reading by title only. Thank you to all. Now, item 12, notice of motion. None have been given to me. So item 3, inquiries and announcements by members of council. I think we should start with Councillor Leblanc tonight. Good evening, Mr. Mayor. No announcements tonight. Thank you. Councillor Brideau. Same thing here, no announcements. Councillor Nolon, I have something to say. I would like to invite all citizens to come to the Santa Claus parade. Saturday in this section of Dieppe is going to be from the intersection of the Champlain and Wheeler to the intersection of Champlain and Paul. So the parade starts at 5 p.m. and we can expect street closures starting 4:30 p.m. So we invite everyone to come to the parade and to start celebrating the Christmas period in great numbers. So we hope to see you Saturday. Thank you. Madame la Conseillère Dallaire. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Nothing tonight. Thank you. Conseiller Godet. Yes, Mr. Mayor. At the last meeting, I talked about the bad condition of the Arsenal way and the Champlain. And I'm happy to see that Arsenal Street or road was repaired. I hope it's going to resist during the winter. On Champlain Street, on the other hand, I don't have good news. I've been told often that there's a truck that lost a ladder. I mean, it's so bumpy that the ladder just got unhinged and left the truck. There's also a wooden board. I talked about a 4x4, and I also talked about springs that drop off of big trucks. And it's not the same person who's telling me about this, and nobody wants to walk on the side of the road. Students of the college don't dare walking along the way. It's too dangerous. I don't know if something can be done this fall, but I mean, we have to do something about that part of the way between Barnes and the city limits. On a happier note, the International Film Festival, Francophone Film Festival in Acadie, worked really well, so I want to congratulate the organizers and the volunteers and the people of Dieppe who have taken advantage of this are very numerous. I'd like to congratulate the Dieppe Entreprise, Spruce Grove, Donna Arsenault, who at 85 years old is still going strong with 160 or 260 employees. I knew him when he was much younger, and somebody who has a lot of energy. So congratulations to him for the award that he won yesterday at the Economic Council ceremony. We talked about adding a part of parking to AGL, going beyond the parking and the sculpture and the trail. I think that, or I'm wondering if this project was continued. We haven't heard anything about it, because people park along the roadway, along they park to the church. It's not too bad. They could cross the street also, but it's starting to be a little bit far, so that adds to the safety question. There's a space farther down where there's been some fill. I mean, if it was graded and worked on during the winter, it could be used, but it's in a hill, so Have we considered making the parking a little bit bigger for the Agi Leblanc Arena? It had been mentioned, but we haven't heard anything. I don't remember it being mentioned, or I don't remember us having talked about it. So I'm mentioning it again, and maybe we should really look into it, because it wouldn't cost that much money, but it would be a project that would help a lot. Yeah, maybe we could mention it during our budget discussions this year, see if it fits in our budget. That's all, Mr. Godet. 4 minutes and 10 seconds. Thank you. Councillor Cormier. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to thank and congratulate citizens of Dieppe for their presence during the ceremonies of the 11th of November. The gymnasium was quite full. And I'd also like to thank citizens for their patience concerning the Marsh project. Thank you in both cases. I think that the question is starting to being asked for the Armistice Day ceremonies, if we could find somewhere where they'll be bigger, because right now I've heard a lot of comments from different citizens concerning that. So it might be something to consider, maybe discussions with our friends. Thank you, Mr. Cormier. Councillor Thibodeau, thank you, Mr. Mayor. The points that I wanted to make were already mentioned by my colleagues, so I have nothing to add. Thank you. Councillor Béliveau. Thank you, Your Worship. I had the opportunity last week, Thursday, to be present at least at half a day at the job fair that was organized for certain careers. I was there for the one for the health care. There were six organizations who were there to encourage youth to study there, to attract them to their field. They were giving them good information. And I noticed that some of them were making appointments to get more information and to discuss further. As you mentioned earlier, when he came back from Granby, the Caroline Savoie was is celebrating her birthday today. So not saying that it's an accomplishment, but there are still other nice things that are coming up for her. So we have much reason to be very proud of her. That's it, Mr. Mayor. Thank you very much. Okay, so I have nothing to add except obviously wishing everybody a an evening in full safety with the Santa Claus parade. I see that it was in Toronto and Montreal last week, so now he's reached Dieppe. That's good. The trip continues. So a good evening to all.